You never will be the person you can be if pressure, tension and discipline are taken out of your life. Good morning students, welcome to SST So Simple tutorial. In the previous class, we learnt about the revolution of France in 1830. The Bourbon kings who had been restored to power during the conservative regime after 1815 were now overthrown by the liberal revolutionaries. Thereafter, a constitutional monarchy is installed with Louis Philippe at its head. This is followed by a revolution in Belgium. Belgium breaks away from the United Kingdom of Netherlands. Then we have seen the Greek War of Independence. The Treaty of Constantinople in 1832 recognized Greece as an independent nation. Today, we will read the subunit named the Romantic Imagination and the National Feeling. Here, we will read about Romanticism and the role of culture in shaping nationalist feeling. The development of nationalism did not come about through wars and territorial expansions only. Culture always plays an important role in the growth of nationalism. So art, poetry, stories, music were all used by the Romantic nationalists to inculcate the feelings of nationalism among the people. Their effort was to create a sense of shared collective heritage. That means they wanted to tell the people that everyone had a common past and that should be respected also. And that is why they should also be independent. Let us look at Romanticism now. It was a cultural movement which sought to develop a particular form of nationalist sentiments. Romantic artists and poets generally reject the emphasis on reason. They view feelings and emotions as superior to logic and analysis. They praise imagination over reason, feelings over logic and intuitions over science. It resulted in new ways of looking at the world. Let us try to see this through examples. In my discussion today, I shall include Johann Gottfried Herder, Karol Kurpinski, Eugene Delacroix and Grimm brothers. So let's start first. Early Romantic nationalists were strongly inspired by the ideas of Johann Gottfried Herder. Herder was a German philosopher. He claimed that true German culture was to be discovered among the common people. Common people are called Das Volk in German language. It was through folk songs, folk poetry and folk dances that the true spirit of the nationalism was popularized. So collecting and recording these forms of folk culture was essential to the project of nation building. Do you remember in the lesson Nationalism in India, we read that nationalism also developed through a movement to revive Indian folklore. Indian nationalists had begun recording folk tales sung by bards and they told villagers to gather songs and legends. If you remember, Natesa Sastri had published a collection of Tamil folk tales named The Folklore of Southern India. Let us come to second example, Karol Kurpinski. He was a pioneer of nationalism in Polish music. He was a romanticist and one of his country's most celebrated composers and conductor of opera. You know, opera is like a play in which everything is sung instead of spoken. He helped to lay the foundations of a national style and prepared the grounds for Polish music of the Romantic period. He celebrated the national struggle through his operas and music, turning folk dances like Polonaise and Mazurka into nationalist symbols. Let us see the third example, Eugène Delacroix. He was one of the most important French Romantic painters. See this painting named The Massacre of Chios. He is depicting an incident in which 20,000 Greeks were said to have been killed by the Turks in the Greek War for Independence in 1822 on the islands of Chios. By dramatizing the killings of Greeks by the Turks, he focused on the sufferings of women and children, and thus he is appealing to the emotions of the spectators and creating sympathy for the Greeks. The massacre of Christians provoked international outrage and led to the increasing support for the Greek cause worldwide. Let us now come to the Grimm brothers. The Grimm brothers, Jacob and Wilhelm Grimm, extensively contributed to the growth of nationalism in Europe. Both the brothers did a tremendous work in collecting folk tales of the past that were passed on generations by elders through oral tradition. They developed an interest in collecting old folk tales. They believed that folk tales were the expressions of a pure and authentic German spirit. They collected several folk tales that expressed pure and authentic German spirit. They were against the French domination and considered it as a threat to the German culture and tried to uproot it through their sincere efforts. They considered their projects of collecting folk tales and developing the German language as form of the wider effort to oppose French domination and create a German national identity. Let us now see the role of language in developing nationalist sentiments. Let us first see the case of Poland itself. Poland had been partitioned at the end of the 18th century by the great powers. Some part was under the occupation of Russia, some with Prussia, and the rest with Austria. There was no country called Poland until 1918, that is the end of the First World War. Polish people were divided, yet they kept alive their nationalist feelings through music and language. Just now we have read about Karol Kurpunski. In the Russian-occupied part of Poland, the Polish language was forced out of school and the Russian language was imposed everywhere. In 1831, an armed rebellion against Russian rule took place, but that was ultimately crushed. Following this, many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Polish was used for church gatherings and all religious instructions. As a result, large number of priests and bishops were put on jail or sent to Siberia by the Russian authority as a punishment for the refusal to preach in Russian. The use of Polish came to be seen as a symbol of the struggle against Russian dominance. Thus, it was also during 1815 to 1848 that the modern phenomenon of nationalism was explicitly formulated. Tired of existing as a loose federation, many people in the fragmented German states hoped for German unification. The various Italian states sought for Italian unification. Numerous groups within the ethnically diverse Austrian Empire dreamt of forming their own nation. The possibility of nationalists achieving their goals greatly frightened the reactionary rulers of Europe, who knew how destabilizing these changes might be. I hope you have understood what is Romanticism and how culture played a role in shaping nationalist sentiments. With this, we come to the end of today's topic. Students, now you should be able to answer these questions. 1. What was Romanticism? Romanticism was an artistic, literary, and intellectual movement that originated in the 18th century in Europe to develop a particular form of nationalist sentiments. The movement glorified folk art and vernacular language. 2. Who was Johann Gottfried Herder? He was one of the famous Romantic German philosophers who claimed that true German culture was to be discovered among the common people or Das 4. 3. How did Romanticism seek to develop a particular form of nationalist sentiments during the 18th century? Explain. Romantic artists were against the glorification of science and reasoning and focused on emotions, intuitions, and mystic feelings. They wanted to create or share a collective heritage, a common cultural past as the basis of nation. Romantic philosophers wanted to create true spirit of nationalism through folk songs, folk poetry, and folk dances. So according to them, collecting and recording these forms of folk culture was essential to the project of nation building. 4. Give examples to show the contribution of culture to the growth of nationalism. I think it's better you prepare this question yourself, in which you include number 1, folk culture, in which you describe about Johann Gottfried Herder. Make music the second point. Explain Carol Korpunsky there. 3. Make use of either Russian occupied parts of Poland or what happened to the Polish people in Russia. So thus you will be able to write 3 points. Next question. Explain the role of language in developing a national sentiment in Europe. The same question I was repeating there as the last point, language. Language played an important role. When Russia occupied Poland, the Polish language was banned and it was replaced by the Russian language. In 1831, an armed rebellion against Russia took place. Though the rebellion was crushed, but it had far-reaching consequences on the people and the learned community of Poland. Many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Polish was used for all religious instructions. Thus, we conclude this subunit. We will see the hunger, hardship, and popular revolt in the next class. For any queries, you can use the comment section and don't forget to subscribe. Till then, happy learning. Thank you.